Raghu Dixit, one of India's biggest cultural and musical export, his recent performance in Singapore was a super huge blockbuster. An interesting genre of music is what he specializes in. You hear his albums and songs, guys, when you can. He literally had people on their feet at this very latest gig at Kala Utsavam at the Esplanade, and we had him on our mic. Exclusively for you, here's Raghu Dixit, the man with the unique brand of infectious happy music, thinking aloud. Raghu Dixit, hi.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm doing really well, thank you.
Okay, so tell us, you're in Singapore. A little about yourself and your interest in music.
Oh well, I'm from Bangalore, South India, and I'm here with my band, the Raghu Dixit Project. We play what we probably can say is the truly a representation of what India is today. Our music is probably the truest representation of what India is today. We are at the core, we are very Indian, and Indian folk to be precise, but then we steal sounds from all around the world, mix it with our own, just like we mix our culture with every other culture possible around the world and call ourselves original. So our music is just that, but the main, if you want me to describe our music, it's just happy and a lot of fun, positive, and absolutely no sad songs.
Thank you. Talking a little about you, do you want to tell us a little about how your interest or journey into music began?
That's a long story. You need a biography for it.
Okay, give me a shorter version if you can. Okay.
I started music when I was 19. Before that, I used to be a classical dancer, which I started when I was 8 and continued till I was 24. But then this moment happened when I was challenged that it is more manly to play the guitar by a classmate of mine. So I took it up as a challenge. In 2 months, I started learning on my own and wrote my first song in 2 months. And since then, I've been playing because it was like finding a hotter woman. So, yeah, I became a musician full time after working for a few years as a scientist, and then came back to India from Belgium where I was working and took up music full time. And it took about 10 years since then to finally find my groove. And we came here in Singapore in 2008 to play for the same festival, Kala Utsavam, but we were placed somewhere outside at the foyer. So it's a great journey out there since last 7 years to move from the foyer to the main concert hall today. So I'm extremely proud of where we started and where we've come today, and really, really happy to come back to this festival and play here today.
Fabulous. So we have a scientist turned musician?
Yeah, you can say that. A scientist turned dancer turned musician, yeah.
Lovely. So let's talk about your band, your group of friends. How did the band come about?
We're not really a band in the technical sense. We're more like a collective. It's an open house for musicians, dancers, shadow puppeteers, painters, anyone, any artist for that matter, to come and collaborate with me and musicians whom I would like to collaborate with. So during my travels, I just meet a lot of musicians and I make it a point to jam with them, and somewhere some spark happens and I like it. And that's how most of my songs are written. I would never claim that I wrote a song. I would always say it was in collaboration with someone, you know. And that's kept my music very dynamic. It's kept changing over the years. It's never been the same thing at all. So my musicians currently are made of 4 friends I made along the road, and they've joined me at various points of time, except Gaurav, who was probably the only original member since 2008 tour,
okay.
who later on went on to become our manager also. And then we have Bryden, who is an amazing guitarist, and we have an Indian flute player, bansuri player named Parth Chandramani. And still yet to get the hang of performing on drums is Nitesh Iyer.
Okay, tell us about your association with Vishal and Shekhar. That's special.
Oh yes, it is very special, simply because that kind of reaffirms my faith that when you need that help, when you need it most, and you beg this God, so-called God, to come, and he doesn't come in, you know, with background score and lightning and all that. Instead, he sends ordinary people like you and I who will do that magic for you in your life. And that's how I see Vishal and Shekhar, who were sent to me at the right time when I probably gave up hopes that music is not going to happen. Because I tried several years to appease several record labels in India to release my album, and nobody were buying my idea of music at all. And that's when Vishal Shekhar heard me in a dark, dingy bar called Zenzi in Mumbai. And they said, we should release your album. Let's start a new record label. And that's how my album came out in 2008, finally, and went on to become the number one non-film music album in India, sold exclusively hand-to-hand at our gigs. And we continue to still do the same thing. We never went to a major record label. We are probably truly indie in everything that we do. Even today, after the gig, we're selling hand to hand our gigs, probably trading sweaty hugs or something like that in return.
Fabulous. So is Bollywood beckoning in a big way for you yet?
Not big way. There have been a couple of opportunities which came my way thanks to my friends in Bollywood industry. Ashish Patil, who is the head of Y Films, in Yash Raj, gave me two opportunities. I did music for Mujhse Friendship Karoge. And then I went on to do another Bewakoofi through Bewakoofiyan. So yeah, I've done a couple of movies. But I do Kannada movies also back home in Karnataka. I've done a couple of movies in Kannada, and then this year I've signed 4 movies, like a signing spree. So yeah.
Great. You performing today, in fact, probably our listeners will be able to hear this interview after your performance. But because I'm talking to you right before your performance, what is it that all the viewers who've come in today, who bought tickets, should be looking forward to? And what is it that you promised them?
I don't make promises. I only expect promises from the audiences that they're not going to watch me like a screensaver. Instead, they're up from their seats and dancing and learning the songs that I teach them and sing along, and because it's going to be a big happy party. We hate to play an audience which is very, kind of pretending to be eclectic or discerning. Instead, we want it to become like a mela, in fact, a celebration. Usually the attempt is to make people forget where they were before they came into that hall and what worries they had in their head, and probably go back to their worries but with a more positive frame of mind and probably perceive it differently.
Fabulous. So I have this very interesting quick pod segment with you to do, which is like a rapid fire, but we call it the quick pod because it is a podcast. So quick questions, quick answers. All right. Genre of music that you totally enjoy listening to and playing?
Folk music around the world, Afro-Cuban, Latin music. I love both of that immensely.
A band that inspired you to create your own little band?
Oh, well, unfortunately, there's never been a band which made me form my band, but the band which I completely love by its philosophy is Dave Matthews Band.
Okay. A line of your song that you relate to in real life and you would want to sing for us?
There's a song called Umber, and it is about how life throws these clues at you to make you believe that perfect love exists in your life, and you keep chasing these clues. Some of us are very lucky to find it early on in our lives, but sometimes we kind of spend lifetimes together to get to that soulmate, whatever. Yeah, I love that song, and it's beautifully penned by a dear friend of mine, Neeraj Singh. So I love that song. Yeah.
Do you want to sing a line? Okay. Have you found the secret love?
Oh yes, many times.
Okay, is Jag Changa for you today?
Absolutely. When people ask me, so now that you're successful, blah, 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 the only thing that I say is that I was successful the day I found my calling by playing the guitar and singing. And it's an amazing experience to just suck in thin air and throw it out in the form of a song. And I've been blessed for the fact that I could make it my profession, and I get to travel around the world and perform in Singapore at the Esplanade Concert Hall and not more anymore at the Foyer. So yeah, it is definitely a blessing, and I completely cherish every day what I do.
So cool. Thinking aloud to you is?
Thinking aloud to me is speaking straight out from your heart, which is what I am. I cannot mince words, and I'm not diplomatic. I have that foot in mouth disease. And yeah, that's what thinking aloud is. Like, whatever you think aloud in your head, you might as well say it out.
Lovely. Thank you so much, Raghu. Wonderful talking to you.
Welcome. Thank you very much, Imani.